Why haven't more? Why don't doctors talk about this? I mean, I'm pretty steeped in, you know, the supplement, the fitness, and the nutrition industry, and I haven't really heard much about it before until Dr. Mercola mentioned it to me. Like, why isn't this more mainstream?
Well, I just think it's a timing issue. I mean, if you look at nitric oxide, when it was known there was something amazing like this back in the 70s, and then you know, it finally won the Nobel Prize in the 1995 or 98 or something. But it still, nitric oxide is just now really receiving the press and the discussions and everything and the awareness that it merits. Well, hydrogen gas, I mean, it's still in its infancy. We have so much more research and exciting things to discover and learn of how it's working. And there's only, you know, 1,000 scientific publications or so, which yeah, maybe it's impressive for just some therapeutic molecule or something. We have 1,000 scientific publications, and it has been shown to be effective in about 170 different human and animal disease models and essentially every organ of the human body. But we do need more studies. And the awareness is really growing exponentially, and the research is growing exponentially. So I just think because there's 7 billion people in the world, and it's quite a new area of research, it's going to take some time. And I predicted that a few years ago, in 2013, 14, I predicted that 2017 would mark the year of the awakening, if you will, in terms of people with the influencers, people like you, Dr. Mercola, some of the big, you know, players, celebrity figures, and professional sports teams, which they would learn about hydrogen and then slowly start promoting that. And that's exactly what has happened. There's a number of celebrities and professional sports teams and players and people out there that are using hydrogen now and talking mm-hmm. about it. But it's just going to grow. It's going to slowly take some time. And so my 2027, another 10 years, I think it will be everywhere. I think doctors will talk about it all the time. I think it'll be a mainstream thing because it doesn't negate the benefits of some other therapy. There's no contraindications, and it is the molecule of life. I mean, it's what started the universe and life, the evolution of life. It's involved in everything, and now the biomedical research is really showing us how essential it really is.
Yeah, it's interesting because you have like oxygen as being one of the main elements that we find super important for life, and hydrogen is on the other end, right? Like that's the balance between oxidation and reduction. So you almost have like this yin and yang type of effect where everybody's talking about breathing and hyperbaric oxygen chambers and, you know, Wim Hof breath work, and it's all about oxygen, 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 but a lot of us aren't thinking about hydrogen. So this is really, really fascinating. The other thing that I noticed was in some of the research, they've looked at a lot of these, I know this is kind of woo-woo, but like these healing waters, right? Like these springs or these curative waters you find around the world. I know there's some sites in Japan and Mexico and Germany, and we hear about sulfur a lot of the time. But correct me if I'm wrong, like a lot of these type of waters that people have turned to traditionally as healing waters have pretty copious amounts of this hydrogen in them.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know that a lot of them do. I know that some of them do, and it is very interesting when you go to the places that are really actually documented to have some beneficial effects. You know, it could be as simple as people are drinking this water and it has some iodine in it, and they're getting better. But there are other things in there, like some of these spring waters, they actually do have hydrogen gas in them, and they're produced either from bacteria or from basalt catalyzed reactions. There's a number of mechanisms for how hydrogen gas can be in these waters, and people have gone and measured them, and you can get small amounts of hydrogen gas. And if you consider that if you're bathing in the water, then the concentration does not need to be so high, because hydrogen gas, it's the smallest molecule in the universe. It's smaller than oxygen. So when you're bathing in the water, that hydrogen gas from the water can diffuse through the cells of your skin and into your blood. And actually studies with bathing of hydrogen water have actually shown increases in blood levels of hydrogen, as well as the breath, exhalation. There's increased levels of breath hydrogen, showing that hydrogen gas really is diffusing into the body and exerting these benefits. So it is very interesting when you consider this whole romantic relationship between hydrogen, oxygen, hydrogen, this primordial first element in existence, and this balances the oxidation and reduction. And then when the two, hydrogen and oxygen, react together, you form the life-giving solvent water. which is the perfect balanced molecule. And now we're learning about the benefits of hydrogen, that oxygen is essential for life, but it's slowly killing you, slowly oxidizing you, just like that apple that turns brown.